another Speed Ink video. Today we're going to check out the PSP Testing Kit. Let's take a look. Alright, and there she is. So basically there's two pieces here. There's the main unit, which houses all the computer stuff, and the AMD drive, DVD drive, all that stuff. And then you have your controller unit, which has basically buttons, a screen, and speakers. I thought this was kind of neat about this one. Obviously it was owned by Square Enix, that's pretty rad. I guess its name was Dario, I'm assuming, you know. And Eliza, maybe she was the one who used it? I don't know. But it's always nice to see stickers on this sort of thing. And on the back we have audio out, VGA out for just connecting to your monitor. Power clip thing for your Wi-Fi if you want it. I guess mine's broken, it should actually stay in there. Oh, prove me wrong. And fan, and some interesting blockages there. Not sure what's under these, some sort of parallel serial sort of thing going on, not really sure. Okay, before we plug her in, we'll plug in this nifty cable in. Just kind of snaps in, and then plug that one in. Okay, now there's two stages of turning on here. We got our base unit turned on, like that, but our PSP is still off. So in this mode, we can choose between... Okay, there's a disc in there. So we can choose between DVD or UMD, depending on what sort of game you're playing. Okay, so now that we've got UMD selected, we'll turn on our PSP unit, just like normal. So on the PSP, we just have like a normal looking interface here. I guess the only thing to note is the debug settings. So you can change the RAM available, 64 or 32 megs. UMD cache, change it between Japanese and US, O button behavior, some other stuffs, DVD speed, you can make it slow down to the UMD, which is not advisable, or just the maximum DVD speed. Random delay, yeah, all sorts of cool stuff. Okay, so it's just like a normal PSP at this point. Just be aware that a lot of the UMD drives are kind of worn out on these things, so buyer beware, I suppose. So yeah, just kind of normal here. Okay, so we'll turn it off. Switch modes. And put in a disc. Here we have Rock Band 2 Alpha. Let's try that out. So as with beta games, you'll find bugs and they'll crash and shit like that, so if it crashes, that's why.
Oh, hey. Modest Mouse. I've never played the finished version, so no idea what's different here. On to the next game. This next one's of an unreleased game called Melody. Gotta make sure the RAM's set up for this one. Oops. Perfect. Yeah, this one takes forever to load. Obviously not optimized yet. Not really sure what the whole purpose of this game is, but obviously they're going for something music-based here. Music analysis. So this is just like a music player, I guess. Look at them all! But yeah, there's Melody. And you can't exit out of this game, I guess, so you just gotta turn it off.
And here's what an official burnt disc would have looked like from THQ anyway. You can see they got different types of build and all that sort of information down there. So, yeah, not everyone did this. They kind of, some of them just burnt DVDs and just wrote on them, but it's kind of cool to come across ones like these.
Now, I'm pretty sure this one's pretty close to final. It's just like a PAL test build, I guess. So I think this was either near or about the release of the norm or the NTSC one. Sure. No idea where the fuck we're going. Just driving around randomly. Which is what I'm gonna do. Fuck you guys. Whoop-ha. Oh, I see. Fuck yeah, I'm going this way. Oh yeah. But yeah, there's that game.
And here's the other supposedly legitimate one I have. This is one of the ones that just has writing on it, so you can't really tell, I guess, for sure. But that's okay. It's got a build of a game on it I want to play.
I have no idea where this one is along its development cycle. It's obviously more finished than the PS2 build I have. Yeah, the tracks have names in these ones, or in this build. Well, let's do a random race. bastards. Oh, thanks. So there you have it. There's a quick look at the PSP testing system, or testing tool. Yeah, I like it quite a bit, actually. It's kind of one of the more unique dev kits. It's got, you know, like a UMD drive and a DVD drive and, like, this PSP controller thing. I mean, you know, the Nitro kits also have their own controllers, but I don't know. It's just kind of cool to have this little mini computer thing that's mostly a PSP. Anyway, thanks for watching my video. We'll see you next time.